Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's another Heathkit audio generator model AG-9A. It is in a very, very good state. This looks quite good. I'm really, really happy about this one. Only a little bit of dust I'm trying to remove with my fingers like that. And all the switches feel like they're all right. This one is not quite tough. As far as I've been able to Google, this one should contain only three tubes. It should be from around 1960. And it was a very, very cheap kit. Look at that, all the knobs, they're original, no drilled holes, no modifications, no nasty things. Even the handle is here and is nice and good. And by the way, about those Heathkit handles, if you take them here in the middle and try and feel, they can crack. So when you lift and you handle old Heathkit stuff, always take your fingers like this all the way out here and have most weight out at the sides, like this. This way you're not gonna crack the handles. I really like it to be as original as possible without any cracked parts, so just take care of your good old stuff. So what I wanna do is power it up and see if it still works. I've been able to look a little bit here on the front panel. I really think this is a funny way they've made this with lines and frequency, so those three knobs, they go together for the frequency setting. And there's a multiplier, of course. So X1, that will be, we just read out the frequency, right? So if we want 60 hertz, now we got 60 hertz, right? And now we got 0 hertz, I think this is just, of course you need 10, right? So 10 is the lowest. Or 1 hertz is the lowest. That is probably not going to work, right? And then you go all the way to 110 hertz. And then you can go 1 kilohertz, 10 kilohertz, 100 kilohertz, right? And the output, there's a really nice attenuator. So this is in dB volts. And yeah, this is 1 volt full scale on the meter here. So that will be here, right? Or that one. Yeah, this is 1 volt full scale. And then you just dial the output until you have this 1 volt. And then you should be happy. And then you go minus 10, minus 20, and so on. So this is in 600 ohm. I guess then this attenuator will work. And if you have 600 ohm internally, now you'll have a load on the internal output. So if you are in case feeding this into a high impedance circuit, of course you need to set the load for internal, then the attenuator will work. Or if your external device is 600 ohm, yeah, hit external and then there's no load here. The buffer circuit and the schematic reveals that there isn't any super isolation or an extra isolation buffer from the oscillator. So I believe we could change the frequency a little bit when we're loading the output, especially with the attenuator here in highest possible output. Then obviously this is directly coupled to the oscillator. So this is something I prepare to experiment a little bit with. But first, let's see if it works. So I believe we're ready to power it up. Let's crank on mains. 100 watts, ooh, yoy, yoy. And then 50 and 40 and 30. We got a lamp. That is good. Oops. Something is, look at the scope. There is not a lot. We don't have a lot of, ooh, and then it stops.
So this is not perfect in any way. Let's see if we can. So the frequency is 980 something, and I think that I set this for a 100 kilohertz. No, 100 times 10, so that is 1 kilohertz, right? Ooh. We got some dodgy. Okay, so far we have established contacts needs to be cleaned. But I think this is really weird. We got only very, very little millivolts of output. So why is that? And if I crank this, okay. I think it is time to have a look inside. There must be some crabbity thingy here. Okay, open time. So this is the inside of this really nice unit. The bulb is working. This is the classic flimsiness of Heathkit, just like you like it. Oh man, let's make all the metal as thin and flimsy as possible. But what the heck happened? See, this is how the plastic around the meter should look like. And over here, it's like, what? So there was a meltdown. Something was very hot down here or something. Or maybe there was even a fire. Wow, that is something. But the meter still works. Yeah, and we got the three tubes. Rectifier tubes and oscillator amplifier thingy, right? I don't know about this kind of... Ah, look at that! This is mains wire outer isolation. This is used for isolation of wire. Not too bad. I think I haven't seen this before. And yeah. This switch definitely need a little bit of love, and this could be why we don't have the quite a... This is the output, right? No, this is the multiplier, and that seems to be working, really? Whoa, look at that. Completely gooped up. And let's clean the parts a little bit. So this is the bottom part of this Heathkit. This is not the most ugly build I have seen, but it is also not the most beautiful one either. We got a little bit of funny modifications, some diodes hanging like this. Is this normal? And that is the level compensation bulb. That will be the high voltage wires from the transformator, right? It goes to this rectifier tube, and what I see here is a disconnected filament for the rectifier tube, and then they just installed a little rectifier, a little bridge rectifier. So that is quite nice way to do it, and just left the tube in the socket. I also like that. Also, what I see here is, I don't know if, I don't want to stick down something of metal, but what I see is some kind of, yeah, I think you can see this around this. So this one should be replaced. This is not too good. So that will be the high voltage. And it goes... Why is it only going... to this one. That is a little bit. Yeah, okay, now I know why. So this is a just a filter choke, I guess. I need to consult the schematic. I don't know if I like this hanging up in the air kind of way. Everything here is just hanging and doing the dingle dingle. And look at that, mains wires just like that. Yips. And look at the switches. Whoa, that is some dirty, dirty. I need to fix this. So this will be the output attenuator. There's just definitely no contact in any of this stuff. And they play with some resistors here. Yeah. All the switches, only that one is nice and clean. Yeah. And what do you call this around the resistors? This white fungus living on off the resistors. That is a little bit interesting. We've got a little bit of green life forms. Or is it just leftover from contact cleaning of this mean green bad stuff? But anyways, I'll go and clean everything up and see if I got output. What do you know? After a lot of cleaning and a lot of poking around with those switches, I got good output. It is reading a little bit low on the meter, so this is should be 1 volt internal load. And what is that? So if I crank this down to 800 on the read out here, it says 730 on the scope. I mean, it's not really bad, right? So 600, and I read 550. I mean, it's not defect. I think it's possible to adjust this. And you see, tons of output as well. So all this seems to be working now, and the frequency is, what is this, 109 kilohertz, so it's, and this is in 100, and okay, so this is my own fault. This one should of course be zero, right? Haha, 996. It's just getting better and better all the time, the more I poke with the knobs. So I mean, this is only a few percent off. And I didn't even touch anything. So that is, ooh, yeah, touch anything. Yeah, this one needs a little bit more love. So this is 100 hertz. Let's see the slowest it can do. So this is 100, 50. I think it says 10 hertz should be the minimum. So this is 10, and this is quite accurate. So if I put this to zero, okay, it creeps. One. Okay, we got output. 5 hertz. Look at that. Yeah, we got 5 hertz. So this is a little bit below spec. Well, let's go up to 10. And yeah. I mean, is this accurate enough for you guys? Wow, so this is, so let's, okay, let's go to, let's go fast. So that will be 10 kilohertz. Okay, and then I crank this down and then this one up. So that should be 100. Let's do a little bit of a massage here. So this should be 100 kilohertz. And it's 98. And then of course I can pump up. I can fine tune a little bit here, and we got 100 kilohertz. So yeah, I just gave it a little bit here, right? And still, let's see how much output we can get at 100 kilohertz. 7 volts RMS, so this is 21 volts peak. Yeah, not too bad for this old sucker from 1960. Just a little bit more cleaning and it's good to go. So this is the schematic. So that will be the three small diodes. They're used for the meter, and then there is a pot called meter control, and then there's this output control. All I have to do is just poke a little bit with the pot for the meter control, and then the meter will read accurately. So yeah, and here's the bulb is in the feedback. As you see here, this is the amplifier tube that went that's going straight out, and then here's the timing back to the grid of the oscillator tube. And this is the rectifier tube that has been bypassed by a normal rectifier bridge, obviously to save a lot of heat and power. As you can see here, the schematic is from radiomuseum.org, so please go there and support those guys. They're doing a fantastic job.